Evening, everyone. Welcome to the Friday Night Final. Lots to cover tonight. We got golf, high school hoops, hockey, and something that may be new to you, cyclocross. But we begin with the hottest team in the area as they prep for a Texas-sized test. Every game now is a test for the number 7 team of the country. Long game of catch-up against UConn Thursday. But in standard fashion with this team, 15 straight wins, they know how to finish. And the numbers keep piling up. First off, they've stayed healthy. Same starting lineup all year. They didn't lose a game without Jermaine Lawrence. The school's highest ranking in 10 years. Sean Kilpatrick leads the conference in scoring at nearly 20 a game now. And while this is the best start under Mick, they're nice numbers. It's just one matters.
I mean, rankings, don't get me wrong, being ranked 7 is absolutely great. I mean, but at the end of the day, you can't let that be who you are. So, I mean, we're just going to do what we do best, and we're not going to look at it. We're number 7 in the team, 7 team in the country, and all that kind of stuff. We're going to think we're Cincinnati basketball, and we're going to do what we do best.
Well, Xavier's back at the Cintas Center tomorrow. The afternoon affair with Providence coming to town. Looking to sweep the regular season series with the Muskies, who have lost now 3 straight. It will not get any easier after Saturday. 4 out of the next 5 are on the road for Xavier. Head coach Chris Mack frustrated, looking for offense anywhere. X has not tallied over 72 points during their current 3-game skid. Friars topped Mack's bunch by 9 2 weeks back. Xavier has not lost to Providence at home, though. Mack's hoping his squad's going to bring a little better effort the second time around.
You know, this is the first time I've ever been through a conference season where you're learning your opponent for the very first time. You can watch tape. You can talk to opposing coaches. You can have seen some of these players when they were high school 3 or 4 years ago. But until you really face the opponents on a nightly basis, it's just been a little different of an experience.
And if you like college hoops around here, you're going to like tomorrow. It's built for you. Kentucky leading things off at 1:30 on the road against Mississippi State. Battle for the bricks in Athens. Miami taking on OU. Friars at the Cintas at 3. Boilermakers in Columbus. NKU looking for a win at home at the Bank of Kentucky Center. UC aiming to run that winning streak to 16 at SMU. Hoosiers in the barn at Minnesota. And hockey, the Clones will host Fort Wayne. Mason freshman Spencer Petrov, he's not your ordinary 15-year-old. When he gets home from school, immediately gets on the bike. And as Mike Burke tells us, that's the price you have to pay if you want to become a champion in a sport called cyclocross.
Cyclocross is a cross between mountain biking and road biking.
And no one in Cincinnati has mastered this relatively new hybrid of a sport, quite like 15-year-old Spencer Petrov.
In the past 2 years, I've gotten silver. So 2 years in a row, right there, so close.
So close to being the national champion in his age group. Spencer comes from a cycling background. Mom was an instructor. And he's completely devoted himself to a sport so few have ever heard of. At first, it was just a fun thing to do.
And then I got into it more and more and realized, wow, this is something I really love and would love to do for the rest of my life, possibly.
Maybe one day it'll pay the bills. Would certainly offset some of the costs his family endures. As you might imagine, there aren't a lot of elite cyclocross competitors here in Cincinnati, which means the Petrovs are on the road, a lot, traveling almost as many miles as Spencer has to cycle.
I really honestly could not be where I am without them. I mean, the support they give me is beyond anything that else they could give.
But it's easy for a parent to do that when they see a son who is more than willing to pay the real price.
So I get home, I'm in the basement working out, then I'm outside riding 60 miles a day after school. I mean, people, like, they don't get that.
People don't have to. Spencer clearly gets it. He's found his passion, and he's going after it just as he did the finish line at his last national event.
It's one race out of your season, and you'd have to be your best form. You got to train all year for it, and it's hard. I mean, it's like one moment, and you have your up days, your down days, you get sick, you get hurt, and it's just something you have to push through to, and I put it together this year to get it done.
After those 2 silver medal finishes, he finally got it done. Mason Spencer Petrov is now his sport's gold standard. In Mason, Mike Burke, Local 12 Sports.
The Cyclones traveled up north to Toledo, fell 3-2 to the Walleye in their only series loss to Toledo this year. Revenge on tap tonight at U.S. Bank Arena. Sumo Friday Night Throwdown. Clones getting fat in the first. Jonathan Hazen to Drew Daniels going backhand to light the lamp. They would add another on Hustle. Joe Cavani behind the net. Josh Buchholz. Almost fans, but gets enough just slide at home. 2-1 lead in the first, but the Walleye got him again with two in the third to win it 4-3. High school hoops, despite three fewer losses overall, Clark still looking up at an unbeaten league summit in the MVC standings. Looking to keep pace tonight at Lachlan. Clark didn't get out to a good start. Pass picked by Jaquan Short, who finishes at the 10 for two. And then in transition, Clark's Malik Rhodes up to sophomore Jordan Gaines. He can finish too. Then Gaines in the half court. Gets it on the baseline using window. Clark wins big 76-46. Redding playing host to Indian Hill. Blue Devils title court on the open court. Not much resistance to the rim. Braves on offense. Lucas Gould with a miss. Shane Boehner there for the rebound and the putback. Boehner with a banner night. Top of the key for three. Pick yourself up, son. Indian Hill wins 43-39. Great new golf center opening on Dixie Highway in Fairfield tonight. At the Miles of Golf, I was honored to MC the VIP party. Anthony Munoz there on hand. State of the art. It's a fitting club, testing center, addition to the indoor-outdoor practice facility and TrackMan with the wooden iron fitting. They've got a SAM putting system. It fits you, helps you correct putting mistakes. Never seen it before. Miles Palooza all day tomorrow if you want to check this puppy out. How about a little second round of the Pebble Beach Pro-Am? Here's the am. Peyton Manning signing an autograph, and then from the bunker, she gets this ball closer than any ever got to the end zone against the Seahawks on Sunday. Phil Mickelson on 14. Runs this birdie in. Phil's five back heading into the weekend. Co-leader is Jimmy Walker. Dynamite on 16, seventh hole on the day. Runs in a long one. He and Jordan Spieth tied for the lead at 9 under.